Hi everyone, my name is Dara. I'm from the Khmer lesson. Okay, welcome back to Learn Cambodian with me again. And the lesson for today is Khmer New Year. Khmer New Year. Okay, then in Khmer you will say Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer. Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer. Okay, but so actually for Khmer New Year, we always celebrate in April, okay, during a dry season, okay, because right now in Cambodia is already April and very, very hot. Okay, so we always celebrate Khmer New Year during this time between like day 14 and 16, mostly around this time, not from 14 to 16 every year, but every year. But because of the spread of COVID-19, so this year, okay, you can have 3 days for holidays, but you cannot go anywhere at all. You cannot go anywhere at all. Yeah, you just stay home. You can like, stay home with your family, but you cannot go out for traveling, okay? Because like all resort, they cannot open. Yeah, they cannot open their business during this time because the government like will not allow, okay, all resort to run their business during Khmer New Year, okay, until like day 20, until day 20. Okay, so yeah, so this time, this year, okay, you cannot go anywhere at all, just stay home. Okay, so yeah, look back to our lesson. This lesson you will learn, okay, what people do during Khmer New Year, and also you will learn some vocabulary from this lesson as well. Okay, so right now if you are ready, okay, let's get started with me together. Okay, so now we can start, okay, this lesson with me together. Okay, the first one you will see is Khmer New Year. Okay, Khmer New Year that I said at the moment that we say Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer. Okay, Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer. Okay, so yeah, Pithi Bon, it means ceremony or festival. But Pithi Bon, ceremony or festival. Okay, but okay, so the first word from this lesson, okay, is to celebrate. Okay, to celebrate. Okay, so when you use the word to celebrate as a verb, okay, in Khmer you will say Thver Pithi. Thver Pithi. Okay, so when you would like to say to celebrate Khmer New Year, okay, in Khmer we will say Thver Pithi Bon, okay, Chol Chnam Khmer. Thver Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer. Okay, so besides Khmer New Year, you can use like to celebrate some ceremony, okay, or another festival, okay, you can use this word as well, but okay, so for the word to celebrate, okay, we say Thver Pithi, nah, Thver Pithi. Okay, so in the sentence, you will see like every year, we celebrate Khmer New Year in April, but we celebrate Khmer New Year in April. Okay, as I told you at the beginning, okay, we always celebrate Khmer New Year in April, okay, between 14 and 16, yeah, every year. Bah. Okay, so this sentence you will say Roal Chnam Yeung Thver Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer Neu Khai Mesa. Roal Chnam Yeung Thver Pithi Bon Chol Chnam Khmer Neu Khai Mesa. Okay, bah. Okay, so Roal Chnam means every year. Nah, Roal Chnam. Okay, and celebrate Thver Pithi or Thver Pithi Bon. Bah, Thver Pithi Bon. Okay. Okay, and yes, like April. Okay, April in Khmer we say Khai Mesa. Nah. Khai Mesa. Okay, so as I told you before already, like for name of the month in Cambodian language, you can use number instead. Nah, you can use number instead. Like for example, April, you can say Khai Bun. Nah, because when you start to count from January, February, March, April, okay, I mean 4, right? Okay, so we say month 4, Thai Bun นะ and most Cambodian people always use number instead of using name ba instead of using name ba because like easy นะ easy like me okay mostly I use number instead of Mesa as well because it easy to speak and easy to understand นะ yeahBecause the reason why is like some people they are not good with this as well. Because sometimes when they want them to tell you about the name, the old name of months in Cambodian in Cambodia, sometimes they have a mistake with this as well. They don't remember like all of this. Nah, okay. So yeah, some people they don't remember the name of the months in Cambodia as well.But okay, so this is why they always use number. But number. Okay, so now I read this sentence for you again. Okay, you will say, รอฉน้ำยึงทวีปิธีบนโจลฉน้ำขมายนึกคายเมษาบ่านึกคายเมษาโอเคบ่าโอเค so next one you will learn the word God or angel บ่าGod or angel, okay. So God and angel, okay. In Khmer, you say Te Vada, Te Vada, nah, okay, Te Vada, okay, okay. Actually, like every year, yeah, there are seven gods, okay, or there are seven angels, and then they rotate, nah, they rotate. Angel rotate every year, okay. So every year, okay, angel like one angel.Okay, like will come to take care of our country every year. Okay, and the name of angel this year is Mundia Devi is the name of the angel for this year. Nah? Okay, and this year is year of cow. Okay, we have 12 animals. Okay, we have 12 animals. Okay, cow.Rat, okay, 12, we have 12. Okay, and for this year, okay, it's year of cow. But the angel, okay, she will not ride the cow, okay, she has its own animal. I mean, okay, you see in the picture, okay, that animal is donkey. Wow. So she will ride a donkey, okay, but as her own animal, okay.So it doesn't mean like year of cow angel have to ride that animal. Okay, it doesn't mean like that. Okay, so all angels, okay, they have their own animal. Nah, they have their own animal. Okay, so for this year, okay, angel will ride donkey as her own animal. Okay, and come to take care of our country. Okay, on Wednesday 14th.Okay, and on Wednesday 14 at 4 a.m. in the morning. Okay, 4 a.m. in the morning. But, okay, so, yeah. During this time, okay, before the God or before the angel come, okay, a lot of Cambodian people, not a lot of Cambodian people, all Cambodian people, okay, we prepare something to welcome that angel. Okay.To prepare to welcome that angel. Okay, so okay, next one you will see like what we prepare for the angel. Okay, so you will see, okay, you see in the picture you will see all of these. So okay, you prepare one table and then you prepare something on the table to welcome the angel. Wow. Okay, so all of this in Khmer we callเครื่องรนดับเครื่องรนดับบ่าเครื่องรนดับนะ but I don't know how to say this word in English but I explain for you like items prepared for the angel okay นะ items prepared in order to welcome the angel okay so all of this we call เครื่องรนดับ okay so if someone know how to say this in English okay just let me know by leavingYour comment, okay, by leaving that word in the comment, okay, and thanks as well, but okay, so all of this we call kreung run dap, okay, and a bit more we learn something from this, nah, okay, like what do we have, But what do we have in this? Okay. Okay. So the okay in this, you will see this one. Nah. From items prepared for the angel, you will see this. This one we call by say, and I don't know how to say in English as well. I don't know. But so okay, when you see this, okay, in Khmer we call by say. By say, nah, okay, by say. Next one, you will see this. Sla thoa dong. Okay, and I don't know how to say this word in English either. I don't know. But so if you know, okay, please let me know as well. Okay. Okay, so you see when you see this, okay, in Khmer we say like this, nah. Sla thoa dong. Okay, dong, maybe you know, but dong, it means coconut. So you see, when you look at the picture, okay, well, that is coconut, nah, okay, that one is coconut, but it's made from coconut, and then, okay, they decorate something on it, okay, so this one we call sla thoa dong, okay, bah. Okay, next item, okay, we will prepare some fruits, bah, we will prepare some fruits. Okay, so in this lesson, I will not detail about the type of fruit. Okay, actually, like to welcome the God during Khmer New Year like this. Okay, like the fruits in the picture, you will see apple. Okay, like many kind of fruit, like longan. Okay, pink apple. Okay, depends on you. But some fruit is not good for this time, nah. Like mangosteen, like durian, okay, so it's not good for this time, okay. But so when you prepare like the fruits to pray for God, to pray for the angel, okay, you have to sing as well. Some fruit is not good, but some fruit is not good. Okay, so I can tell you briefly in for this, okay, for fruit that Cambodian people like to use during this time, okay, like in the picture, like apple, like pear, okay, pink apple, longan, okay, and beside this, okay, we have like watermelon, okay, coconut, okay, nah, but and yes, we have more, okay, for this, okay, so yeah. This is one item, okay, that we prepare for angel as well, but fruits. Okay, next item, okay, you should have flower in the waist. Okay, so you prepare some flowers, okay, like in the picture, you see? In the picture, yeah, we have many kind of flower. Okay, so, yeah. Prepare it to put in the waist, like in the picture, like this. Nah, okay. So for the word flower, okay, in Khmer you say, paka, paka, ba paka. Okay, and next one, okay, you also have some beverage, okay, but only soft drink, nah, only soft drink, okay. To pray for God, to pray for angel like this, okay, you cannot like use beer. Or alcohol, okay, to for God or angel, okay, it's not good. So we always use soft drink, okay, like Coca-Cola, Fanta, Sprite, and pure water as well. But okay, so for the word beverage, okay, we say hesejak, nah, beverage, okay, but soft drink. You see, I remark for you, soft drink, okay. Okay, next one you have to have, okay, you might have to have is candle. Okay, candle. In Khmer you say tien. Tien, nah, candle. Tien. Okay, ba. Okay, and next one, okay, incense. Okay, next one, incense. Okay. Okay, so before the angel comes, okay, Cambodian people prepare everything already, okay, and then when the angel comes at 4 a.m, okay, all Cambodian people have to light incense, have to light incense and then pray for God, pray for angel, and then wish their family to have good luck in the life, happiness in the family. Okay, but so yeah, we have to do like this when the angel comes at the time. Okay, like this year at 4 a.m. So yeah, we need to get up early in the morning to wait for the angel and light incense, light candles, okay, and then to pray for something, okay, to bring happiness to your family, to bring good luck to your family, okay, and for someone you would like to wish for, okay. Okay, so this is the first day that Cambodian people do during Khmer New Year. During Khmer New Year, okay, and after lighting the incense, okay, you have to keep we have to keep like all of these items for 3 days, okay, until end of Khmer New Year, okay, and then you can light incense every day, one time per day for 3 days, okay, and then yeah, that's finished. Okay, so this is the first day for Khmer New Year, okay, for Khmer New Year. Okay, so right now we already finished with this. Okay, so now learn something about next day. Okay, so first day already finished, and next day, okay, most Cambodian people, they always make food and then bring food to the pagoda for monks. Okay, but so okay, in this point you will learn the word for pagoda. Okay, so pagoda in Khmer you say what? Wat, nah, pagoda. Okay, so next day, okay, most Cambodian people, especially like old people, but they always bring food to the pagoda for monks, okay, living in that pagoda. But for this year, maybe maybe not next day, yeah, they will go to the pagoda at the same day, because we start to welcome the angel in the early morning at 4 a.m. So like the sky still dark, okay, so maybe after they pray something, they go back to sleep, and then in the morning at 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock, okay, they start to make food and then go to the pagoda at the same day, okay, because like yeah, it different from previous year or from last year, okay, but we go to the pagoda in the next day, but this year, okay, at the same day, but okay, so yeah, so next day or this year at the same day, okay, in the morning, people go to the pagoda, but go to the pagoda. Okay, and then, okay, we learn about like, about hometown. Okay, hometown. So for during this time, like Khmer New Year and Phichum Ban Day, okay. So for we have 2 holidays. Per year that Cambodian people that they have hometown in the province, okay, they will go back to their hometown during this time, okay, Khmer New Year and Phichum Ban Day, okay, only two of these that they have to go back to their hometown. But yeah, this year, as I told you, because of COVID-19, they cannot go back to their hometown. They have to stay in Phnom Penh. Nah? They have to stay in Phnom Penh. Okay, but okay, so for the word hometown, okay, in Khmer we say Srok Komnat. Srok Komnat. But for spoken Cambodian people, just say Srok only. They understand. But Srok, only this is in Nana. It means hometown, ba hometown. Okay, so yeah, again for the word hometown, you can say srok and srok komnat. Okay, okay. So for during Khmer New Year and Phichum Ban Day, okay, Cambodian people that they have hometown in the province, okay, they will go back to their hometown 1 day or 2 days before Khmer New Year. Okay, but because like for Khmer New Year and Phichum Ban Day, Cambodian people will have like 3 days for holidays, and then if sometime like if the end of the ceremony is on Friday, maybe they can continue their holiday until Sunday as well, so they will like have longer holiday for 5 days. Yeah, okay, so yeah, sometimes it's good as well, but because you have like long holiday with your family, okay. Okay, but and this year also like end of Khmer New Year is on Friday. Yeah, and some company, some place, okay, they don't need to work on Saturday, so they can like they will have like 2 days more. Yeah, 2 days more for holiday. So yeah, it's longer. Yeah, it's longer. Okay, so yeah. So when they go back to their hometown, they meet their family, and then okay, they will go to the pagoda as well in their hometown, and then okay, some people they meet their friend, okay, and then they have a party, okay, with each other, okay, and then for the word party, okay, in Khmer you say, chup lieng, ba, chup lieng.Okay, so when they have a party, they drink beer, they eat a lot, drink a lot, and a lot of people get drunk, okay, during that time. Okay, but very happy, very happy. Okay, okay, so for the word party again, we say chup liêng, ba, chup liêng, ba. Okay, and then, okay, beside this, some people, they play Khmer traditional game.My traditional game, wow, okay, but so my traditional game, okay, in Khmer we say lap bang pro pay ni Khmer, lap bang pro pay ni Khmer. Okay, so we have many kind of my traditional game. Yeah, maybe next video or yeahI will prepare the video for the name of my traditional game for you. Okay, ba. Okay, so we always play my traditional game in the pagoda, in the village. Okay, ba ba. And some people, yeah, they don't care about it. They just have a party with their friend and drink and then get drunk. Okay, but some people, yeah, especially like a woman, yeah, women, they don't like drink.King beer, and then okay, they play Khmer traditional game together with their friend in the village. Okay, ba ba ba. Okay, so I read this for you again. Khmer traditional game. Okay, lap bang pro pay ni Khmer ba. Lap bang pro pay ni Khmer. Okay, ba. Okay, and one more point.Okay, for some people as well, especially people living in Phnom Penh. But people living in Phnom Penh, okay, their hometown is already in Phnom Penh, so they don't need to go anywhere during this time, okay? So besides going to Pagoda, okay, maybe 1 or 2 hours, okay, they continue their trip to different resorts in Cambodia.Okay, yes, some people they go to this province, some people they go to that province. Okay, depends on them. Okay, so for the word resort in Khmer you say Rom Mani Yathan. Rom Mani Yathan. Okay, so in Cambodia there are a lot of resorts, okay, that you can go to visit. Okay, like natural resorts, you can see a lot of forestMountain, okay, but very nice. But this year, home sweet home, okay, home sweet home. Hi, okay, you cannot traveling, you cannot travel to anywhere at all, nah. Okay, you cannot. But okay, so again for the word resort, okay, we say Rom Mani Yathan, okay. Yeah, so some people they go to different resorts in the morning and then back home in the evening, and some people, okay, they stay at that resort for one night and then they back home in the next day. Okay, so depends, nah. Okay, but okay, yeah, so yeah, that's all for our Khmer New Year. Okay, and one more thing, like some people they go to the pagoda for 3 days. Yeah, some people they go only the first day and then next day and then after next day, okay, they go to different resort. But some people, okay, they go to the pagoda every day or every morning, okay, first day, second day, and third day, eh? Okay, especially old people, young people, yeah, some people sometimes they don't care about going to the pagoda okay นะ okay so just first day and then two more days okay go to visit different places okay okay yeah so yeah we have only this for Khmer New Year and for Chum Ban Day okay the same we do like this as well go to hometown go to pagoda and go to some resort as well bye okay that's all for this lesson and thanks for watching okay I hope everyone enjoyed this lesson and I hope it's useful for you to know about our tradition to know about our culture and to know about Khmer New Year as well okay so if someone like still not understand or still not clear with some points from this lesson okay just let me know by leaving your comment below and I will come to you in the next videoOkay, thanks for watching again and stay safe and have a great day. See you next time.